Vision is really necessary for an organisation to have. Vision is a picture. It's almost like with a paintbrush that you can paint it. And a powerful vision is a shared one. One person or a leader with a vision and everyone follows behind is not as powerful as a shared vision. And if other people are using the paintbrushes to help paint that picture, the stronger that vision is and more likely that vision will be found by everyone involved. So it's like a good idea. A good idea can come out of anything, but making it work, that's the real hard bit. And I think the hard bit about vision is getting that shared paintbrushes, the shared vision, and I think it's absolutely critical for success that happens.
For me, leaders need to be master storytellers. The vision thing is incredibly important, and you've got to have a clear vision of where you want to be. In strategy, we talk about clear and fuzzy strategy. You've got to be clear about what you want to achieve, but fuzzy enough to take advantage of things along the way. But I think as a leader, you need to, particularly in the rapidly changing world we find ourselves in, depending on business you're in particular as well, it's been challenged. If I was in a business now that perhaps is going to be challenged by Alibaba or Amazon, I'd have to be making sure that I painted a picture of the future which was positive, realistic but positive, and selling that to people. Not everyone is resilient as we are, and not everyone is as future focused as we are, and not everyone can imagine a future that we can and want to be part of that. And I think part of a leader's job is to continue painting that picture of where we're going and how we're going to get there, and showing some of those, I suppose, those old-fashioned traits of leadership that we don't tend to talk too much about because it sounds like it's come out of a boy's own annual, you know. Things like resilience and courage, those types of things. And I think for a leader, you know, we talk about leadership being the great communication and leadership being about listening, and I think leaders need to listen and pay attention, but you need to be able to sell. And so I believe you need to be a master storyteller. Not great rambling stories that are too complicated, but the classic little springboard stories where, you know, one or two protagonists, or maybe a single protagonist, overcomes an issue. It's the old hero story. Overcomes an issue. We find out how they did it, and then there's a moral in the tale. And I think the more of those you can tell, some of them from the past, about how you've overcome things in the past, but some of them purely future-oriented, will get people more likely to step off and follow you. But you've got to be prepared to step off first.
Yeah.
But give them the courage to step off after you, because you've told such a compelling story, they want to be in the next chapter with you.
I think it's really very important. In fact, I think it's non-negotiable as a leader that you believe in the cause. If you don't, people will see you're not authentic. Now, you know, it depends where you're leading to. If you're a leader in a very large organisation and your leadership really focuses most particularly around the leadership of your discipline or your particular area of the business, you really need to focus on that and believe in that. You might have some question marks in your mind about the broader vision, so you may be able to get through a situation where you might have some questions about the broader vision, but for that area that you are leading, you must believe in it. Well, frankly, if you don't believe in it, you can't deliver, because it's not there, it's not in your heart, and people will see it as such.